इन्वायरमेंटल साइंस सब्जेक्ट कोड 333 सीनियर सेकेंडरी कोर्स मॉड्यूल 1 लेसन 2 इन्वायरमेंट एंड ह्यूमन सोसाइटी पार्ट 2। हेलो लर्नर्स, वेलकम टू आवर इन्वायरमेंटल साइंस प्रोग्राम एट सीनियर सेकेंडरी कोर्स इन NIOS। इन द प्रीवियस प्रोग्राम वी डिस्कस अबाउट नेचुरल रिसोर्सेज दैट इज एबायोटिक एंड बायोटिक इंटरेक्शन बिटवीन प्रिमिटिव सोसाइटी एंड एनवायरमेंट डेवलपमेंट ऑफ डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ टूल्स एसेट्रा। I am Neelam Gupta, course coordinator of EBS, welcomes you in this program. We will now discuss discovery of fire, how settled life began, about evolution of agriculture, how industrialization began and how exploitation of the resources started. So objectives of this program are to understand the discovery of fire, evolution of agriculture and domestication of animals, invention of wheel, identify factors that led to growth of industrialization, how rapid industrialization has resulted in depletion of natural resources and environmental degradation. Now come to the fire. The primitive Homo erectus discovered fire more than 200,000 years ago. Discovery of fire had a great influence on their lifestyle. They realized that use of fire enabled them to colonized the colder parts of the earth. They also found that meat becomes tender when cooked in fire, making it more digestible. Fire was also used to scare away dangerous animals. Fire brought about cultural evolution of humans as well as increasing exploitation of natural resources. Now come to the agriculture and domestication of animals. Dear learners, we know that lives of primitive human dependent largely on the availability of food. They had small families which included children and grandchildren. They roamed in forest for food and lived in caves. Man, the hunter, was dependent on his luck in chasing and hunting as also on the abundance of animals. Once humans settled down, they slowly began to farm and a primitive agriculture society was formed. Continuous cultivation along riverbanks and valleys became surplus and domestication of animals and raising of cattle began. The first domesticated animal was dog. As time passed, humans learned to use metal tools for agriculture and use plant and animals residue as manure. They also began irrigation of their cultivated field. Further improvement in cultivation and domestication of animals encouraged human settlement by the riverbanks and valleys. Thus evolved the so-called agro-horticultural societies, or we can say the primitive agrarian society, evolved and practiced traditional agriculture. These primitive humans needed to till the land for farming and also move from one place to another, so they started using bullocks to till the land and some other animals such as camels, elephants, bullocks, etc. as a means of transport. The animals used for carrying goods from one place to another are called draught animals. Early humans also reared animals for food such as the goat, sheep, pig, deer and poultry birds. Now question arises, how did early humans carry out trading? Once humans became permanent settlers, their population began to increase, natural resources got depleted and those arose the need to get material from outside. Also culturally, their requirements for food, for clothes and ornaments and agricultural implements etc. increased. Now we come to the invention of wheel. They did not directly involve in farming, Those don't repeat, those not directly involved in farming became craftsmen. Surplus agriculture produce was bartered for non-essential goods such as pottery, ornaments, etc. It took a long time for the animals to carry the goods from one place to another. Thus came the invention of wheel and carts pulled by animals. No one exactly knows who invented wheel, but people were using it around 5,000 years ago in Iraq, Turkey and Syria. The first wheels were probably round slices of log. The logs could roll objects on a plank of wood kept on the logs. The first wheeled vehicle, no one exactly knows who invented wheel, but people were using it around 5,000 years ago in Iraq, Syria, Turkey, etc. The first wheels were probably round slices of log. The logs could roll objects on a plank of wood kept on the logs. The first wheeled vehicle was a chariot, which was a two-wheeled cart pulled by donkeys and then by horses. Greeks and Romans used them when fighting wars. Now we come to the discovery of wheel. By about 3000 BC, wheels made of logs were being used in primitive carts. The solid wooden wheels were used for other purposes too, such as by the porters to mold earthen and terracotta pots. Around 1000 BC, these were known as the potter's wheel. Wooden wheels were heavy, and once metals were discovered, metal wheels with spokes replaced wooden wheels as they were much lighter and stronger. Now, beginning of the industrialization, a more secure food supply and improved diet made agricultural communities move to new lands for farming. It also led to a substantial increase in population. Some people became miners. They mined flint to make flint axes, to mine flint from rocks. Miners used deer antlers and shovels made from shoulders blade of cattle. They worked by the light using small lamps made from hollowed piece of chalk containing animal fat and wicks made of moss. Thus, growth of agriculture was accompanied by growth of tool making that provided crude agricultural implements. Flint axes were important for farmers for clearing dense forest land to raise their crops. Stone axes were used to fell trees, thus making wheels, constructing buildings, mining ores to make tools and ornaments were a step towards industrialization. Next came to the discovery of metals. The use of metal was first discovered in Iran and Turkey approximately 8000 years ago. The early use of copper and gold was for making ornaments. 2000 years later, humans began to make copper axes and weapons with sharp cutting edges. Soon, smith mixed metals and produced bronze from copper and tin. This alloy was harder and easier to cast into knives and axes. By 2500 BC, bronze became the dominant metal. From 1000 BC, farmers had better axes, sickles and knives. Carpenters also had better tools. Humans discovered that copper, iron and bronze made stronger tools. This discovery brought humans out of the Stone Age and marked the beginning of industrial revolution. The potters were using high temperature kilns or ovens to fire their wares accidentally they discovered that lump of gold and copper has melted at high temperature and could be molded into shape. So the metalsmith discovered that intense heat could extract copper from metal bearing ore buried in rocks. This process is now called smelting. From Bronze Age to Iron Age, from 7th and 6th century BC, humans began to use iron to make weapons and found it to be much superior to bronze. By 1200 BC, Western Asia had came out of the Bronze Age and entered into the Iron Age. Iron tools and weapons replaced those made from bronze. Now come to the growth of industrialization. Factors that led to growth of industrialization: first, technical development; second, economic development; third, invention of wheel; beginning of mining, agriculture, Bronze Age and Iron Age, and language. Now I am going to talk about each of these factors. First, technical development. The discovery of metals for making better tools and weapons initiated technology. Second, economic development. The establishment of agrarian societies where people engaged themselves in selling surplus produce or bartering it. This made them economically sound. In the agrarian society, people got busy with occupations other than agriculture. Next factor is the invention of wheel. This led to faster transportation and marked the beginning of the transportation industry. Not so long ago, humans traveled by bullock cars. Today, cars, buses, trains, and aeroplanes are a common sight. Next important factor for the growth of industrialization is mining. With the unearthing of flint came the concept of mining. Later, ores containing copper, iron, and aluminium were mined. This led to the formation of mining industry. Next is cultural development. Now comes agriculture. We all know that agriculture began with primitive humans. Today, agriculture is a means of livelihood for millions of people. Modern farming methods have produced food for millions of people. Agriculture itself has become an industry. It has also led to the formation of food industry, so much so that even ready-made breakfasts are now available. Next factor for the growth of industrialization is Bronze Age and Iron Age. Bronze and Iron Age and the discovery of fire much earlier led to the making of machine tool industry. Machines for making synthetic cloths, for printing cloths, ushered in textile industries. Last factor is language. Do we know that language is very important factor for growth of industrialization? Humans are the only animals endowed with a well-developed capacity for speech. Spoken communication led to development of language. Language helped in working groups, which enhanced the pace of economic development. Growth of industrialization means exploitation of natural resources. So, beginning of exploitation of natural resources, environment has its own means of attaining a balance and replenishing and recycling its lost resources. Then how are the environmental resources getting diminished or depleted? Overexploitation, value erosion, loss of capacity of containment and greed of humans has depleted natural resources. Above all, there is lack of awareness. Forests have been cut to make place for agricultural fields, houses for human habitation, roads, railway lines, and excessive use of wood not only for burning but also for commercial purposes. Loss of forest has endangered wildlife, and some of them are already extinct. This is now excessive generation of waste, which has polluted land, hills and water bodies. Pollution has changed the climate and caused disastrous havocs. The scenario is scary. Let us trace the events which has led to this scary scenario. The Neolithic period saw the humans giving up their nomadic life. They started exploiting the environment more intensively, started leading a settled life. This was the age of agriculture. As population grew, people started migrating to different parts of the world. Human exploration of the environment intensified. During the Industrial Revolution, the exploitation of the environment further intensified. Rapid expansion of industrialization has resulted in depletion of natural resources and environmental degradation. If we ponder for a few minutes, we shall be amazed by the vastness of natural resources and how humans over the last few centuries have exploited environmental resources such that its damage and degradation have reached enormous proportions. It is all about discovery of fire, beginning of settled life again, evolution of agriculture, starting of industrialization and beginning of exploitation of the resources. Now the time to sum up for whole content in terms of what you have learned so far. Later human discovered fire and used it for cooking, driving away predators and capturing large animals. Second, from a nomadic life, humans began to settle and make shelter. Around 12,000 years ago, humans learned to cultivate crops. Agricultural practices improved and humans grew enough food and their population increased. Next, surplus cultivated crops was transported to other places and were bartered. Wheat was discovered and transportation became easier. They moved to newer places to raise new crops and also began to domesticate animals. While primitive humans were mining flint to make tools, they came across metal ores, and mining and refining metals by heating began. They made lots of things with bronze, an alloy of copper and tin, and later with iron. Soon they started manufacturing activities and thus began industrialization. Rapid expansion of industrialization has resulted in depletion of natural resources and pollution of the environment. The survival of humans is now threatened because of environmental degradation. Overexploitation of natural resources should be stopped. Stop polluting natural physical resources. We should think about generations which not yet to come. Develop empathy. There is more pleasure in thinking for others than self. Dear learners, this is all about the environment and human society. We will come again to meet you with a new program of environmental science. Thank you.